So in this lesson, we're going to be trying to figure out what is a limit. What does it mean to take a limit of a function? So we're going to start by looking at this picture right here. And we have a function, but it's behind this window. So you have, you know, you have your window and your curtains and everything, and you look out the window and you see a function. And so we're asked this question, which is, what is happening when x is 2. So if we look on the graph right here, we can't actually see when x is 2. There happens to be a bar over the window right there. But we can make a really good guess. What do you guys think is happening there? What do you think the y value is when x is 2? Yep, it looks like it's 4. You know, here's your graph. If it went like that, it would be 4, right? It'd be a point right there. But the thing is, we don't actually know that for sure. If we move the window, it could be that we have a point here at 4, which is what we guessed. But there could actually be a hole at 4, or there could be a point somewhere else that's not at 4. And so what we've done by saying it looks like it ought to be at 4, even though I don't really know exactly what's happening at 2, because at 2 there's this bar in the way, right? What we've done is we've found the limit as x goes to 2 of our function is 4. So that means if I look on either side, but I can't see exactly what's going on right when I am at 2, I'm going to guess that the answer should be 4. And if we look at what our definition is here for limit, we would say the limit of f of x as x approaches, in our case 2, equals, in our case 4, means that we can make our function value, our y value, as close as we want to 4 by taking x as close as we want to 2. So if we go back and look at our picture again, with that bar in the way, as long as I can look and I can see if we're really close to 2 on the x-axis, I'm looking at the function on either side of the bar, and I'm saying the closer I am to 2, my function's getting closer and closer to having a y value of 4. And if I move that bar out of the way, in all three of these situations, whether there's a hole or there's a dot somewhere else, in all three of these situations, on either side of that actual point, the closer and closer the x value gets to 2, the closer and closer the y value gets to 4. So we would say that in this case, in all three of these cases, no matter what's actually happening at 2, the limit as x goes to 2 of f of x is 4. Now there's one other way to think of limits, other than the window pane, that also can be helpful. And that's to think of your function as actually like a roller coaster or a road that you're driving on. And so in this example, we're looking at the function x minus 1 over x squared minus 1 as x gets close to 1. So I imagine that I'm this car right here, and I'm driving along the function. And if I drive so that my x value gets closer and closer to 1, where is my car going? So where is the road going? That's what we're asking ourselves. And the road is going to be at a height of 5.5. And it doesn't matter which direction I'm coming from. If I'm coming from this side over here, as I'm driving along with my little car, I'm still getting close to a height of 0.5. Now, in our analogy here, we seem to have a pothole or something at exactly at that spot. But it doesn't matter because that's where the road is headed. And so we would say that the limit here, according to this graph, is 0.5. So that's the idea of a limit. Where is the graph headed as you get close to the point? What's going on near the point? But the big idea here is that we don't care what's actually happening at the point. So for example, if we have f of x being x minus 1 over x squared minus 1, then if we try to actually plug in 1 here, we're going to get 1 minus 1 over 1 minus 1. We're going to get 0 over 0, which doesn't make any sense. We can't divide by 0, right? So we can't actually plug the point in, but we can still say something about it. We can say that it's getting close to 0.5.